You know what's so cool about the Bible? That if you crack it open and unpack certain scriptures, especially in the books in the Old Testament of Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, it shows you exactly how to have a life of wealth, health, prosperity, and happiness. And I've discovered 5 biblical principles that will keep you broke in this episode of the 7 Fear Squad happening in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them trenches, now I'm making 7 figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from the Money Smart Home Office here in the suburb of downtown West Chicago. And welcome to another Sunday biblical Bible study that currently right now we're calling the Biblical Baller Breakdown, but that is a working title. Why? Because we've launched a contest since we hit 60,000 subs saying, hey, we'd love to bless you to help us come with a name for the Sunday night Biblical Bible series. So again, a contest that we're going to award once we hit 75,000 subs is we need your help to help name these episodes on Sunday nights of how to look at the Bible as it relates to health, wealth, prosperity, and happiness. What do we call this series? And if you put it in the comment section below, what will inspire you, what God may place on your heart, well, we should label these episodes on Sunday nights here on the YouTube channel called the 7 Fear Squad, a channel that helps you become a first generation cash flow millionaire. The one we pick to properly title these Sunday night episodes is going to get from us to you a $500 cash check, money order, gift card from us to you. And we're also going to give you $500 to your favorite church or charity in your name. So $1,000 on the table we want to award to you when you help us come with a name for these Sunday night Bible studies. And we're going to award that once we cross 75,000 subs. Okay? Okay, so let's get right into it. What are the things in the Bible that will actually help you get wealthy according to biblical principles, or what will keep you broke according to biblical principles? Well, what is it really after? What is it that you want? You know, oftentimes people pursue their career, their job, their business, their field of study, their endeavors, their dreams. Why? Because they want health, they want wealth, they want to make a greater contribution to the community, their family, their society. They want to live in a life of prosperity. They want to have fulfillment in their life. They want to live a long life. Well, some other things. They want freedom. They want independence. They want power. They influence. Whatever is it that you're after, guess what? You can get it if you follow certain biblical principles. But what are all these really after? What is it that you really want? What does these all manifest? I mean, if you can have all the money in the world, if you can have all the fulfillment, the long life, what are you really after? Do you know what you're really after? It's one word. It's one word. Here's what these things all translate down to. One thing, and it's called happiness. Yes, you want happiness. You want wealth. You want influence. You want contribution, right? All these different things. You want to have a participation in the next generation to create a community center, to get involved in your church or a nonprofit. Why? Because you feel happy doing it. However, if you go about those plans according to the Bible in this manner, guess what? You're going to be broke. You're going to be dissatisfied and you're going to be unfulfilled. And ultimately, you're going to be not happy. So according to scripture, what should you avoid? So let's unpack this. Number one, according to Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 10, you should not look for wealth, health, happiness, prosperity in the wrong places. Let's check this out. Scripture says, whoever loves money never has money enough. Whoever loves wealth is never satisfied with his income. This too is meaningless. Now, this is the book written by King Solomon. And King Solomon is regarded as the wisest and richest king who ever lived, who took the population of God's people through a golden age. Everybody was happy, everybody was wealthy, everybody was prosperous. Why? Because he taught his people not to look for wealth and riches and happiness in the wrong places. Now, Ecclesiastes, most likely during these chapters, was written towards the back half of King Solomon's life when he realized that his pursuit of happiness and just prosperity in the wrong places led to what he calls vanity. that looks good on the outside, but the inside, it was meaningless. If he just sat in a pile of money just for the sake of sitting on a pile of money, it was vanity. If you want a title, position, control, lands, for just the sake of those type of things, it was vanity. It was meaningless. So you have to ask yourself, what is it all for? What is your money, your wealth, your pursuit of happiness going to do for God's kingdom, for God's purpose, for God's use, using you as a messenger and or an example to bless other people? What is it all for? That's a question you got to ask yourself. If you're going to make a lot of money, if you're going to have titles, if you're going to have a business, you're going to have power, influence, a government position, what is it all for? Is it for the sake that you just did it? Because that is vanity. What is the meaning behind it? So therefore, you're not looking for success, wealth, and happiness in the wrong places. Number two, avoid this. A lack of gratitude. Let's look at Proverbs chapter 20, verse 12. All right, it reads like this. Ears that hear and eyes that see, the Lord has made them both. So what does that mean? What is it that your eyes are seeing? What is it that your ears are hearing? In that, you should be grateful. God has given those things to you. So whatever that's you're experiencing, are you writing down a list of things that you're happy about versus things that you don't have? See, it's very easy to go about life to say, you know what? I got my eyes on this. I got my ears and attention over here. But man, I'm not happy about what's right in front of me. My family, my current job, my business. Now I need to make the most of it. But is my eyes and my attention elsewhere? Or am I grateful for what God has placed right before me? In that pursuit, you should find happiness through gratitude. Number three, something to also avoid is envy. Let's look at Proverbs chapter 27, verse 4. It reads like this. Anger is cruel and fury overwhelming, but who can stand before jealousy? See, what scripture is saying is, hey, anger is bad. Fury is worse, but man, nothing can stand up to envy. Because it's never enough. When you envy, it's never enough. What you're seeing in envy is like, wow, everybody has everything that I don't have. Again, back to lacking of gratitude. And I envy and I covet what other people have. It brings out a bunch of sinful behaviors and nature about you that says, I'm not grateful for what I have. Or more importantly, envy also brings out the fact that you are unwilling to work for what you want, what you desire, what God has placed in your life. And therefore, instead of working towards it, envy takes over. So what else does the Bible say about keeping you broke in a bad situation? Well, it's number four, entitlement. If you read in Proverbs chapter 1, verse 2, it says like this. All a man's ways seem right to him, but the Lord weighs the heart. You see, if all your mindset and perception is what everybody owes you, what the government needs to do for you, what somebody else needs to do for you, because it's your ways, you seem right. So in other words, if people say, you know what? People owe me this. People owe me that. I'm this, I'm that. Well, guess what? You're right. But the Lord God weighs your heart. If you're constantly in a situation where you're not grateful, you're not happy, you're not content with what you do have, and the opportunities presented to you and manifesting the most out of them, guess what? You're always feeling entitled. You're always going to feel that companies, employers, insurance companies, the government, some outside entity is supposed to make you happy, wealthy, and prosperous. And number five, what keeps you broke is you only trust yourself. What? Well, let's take a look at this. Proverbs chapter 28, verse 26. It reads like this. He who trusts in himself is a fool, but he who walks in wisdom is kept safe. You see, if you think that you know everything about everything because your ways are right, well, guess what? You're right to yourself, but what does God say? God says you're a fool. What does a fool mean? Foolishness is this. It means you are stuck all in your feelings. Our feelings are subject to an emotional roller coaster. You see, scripture says a man that only trusts in himself is always going up and down. One moment we're happy, the next we're sad or depressed. One moment we're filled with love, the next we're driven by anger. One moment we're full of confidence, the next we're filled with fear and worry. The person who trusts solely in his own heart is ultimately betting his future upon his own finite knowledge and the whims of his feelings. No wonder Solomon calls this foolishness. See, one thing I understood is that I can't be it. I can't have the right markers of choosing the right wife, the right business decision, the right business opportunity, if it's just left up to me. So I can't trust only myself. Why do you think businesses have boards? Why do you think people that take public money from the stock market have conference calls, quarterly earnings reports, accountable to the public to whom they take investment money from? Because not just trusting themselves, there's a board of directors, there's people that they're responsible to and accountable to, and guess what? They're not only trusting themselves, they're trusting the counsel of people wiser that have walked these paths and experiences further and farther than they have currently. So if you want to pursue health, wealth, contribution, prosperity, fulfillment, long life, freedom, independence, power, and influence, how should you go about doing according to biblical principles? Well, number one, consider being grateful. Be grateful in all things. You know, sadly, our country is lacking this. Listen, every Friday, I wear red. You know why? It stands for remember everyone deployed. Because I remember when I was deployed overseas. I was in two different deployments, combat tours. In my 8 years in the Marine Corps, I had three tours. Two of them were combat tours. And I remember telling myself all the time, in the mix of things, in the heat of the moment, when things were chaotic, I always tell myself this: if I get back to America, I would do this. You know why? Because I really appreciate what America brought to me. I was grateful for the opportunity to be in America. I was grateful for just a hot meal. I was grateful for running water. I was grateful for having paved roads. I was grateful for running water. I was grateful for all things. So if you want to have health, wealth, and happiness in your life, well, consider an attitude of gratitude. How many of you know that saying? Your attitude is your altitude. The reason why most people suck at some of their goal settings is this: because they lack a great attitude, and their attitude sucks. And God can't bless you if your attitude sucks. Number two, consider removing a sense of entitlement. Listen, I tell my kids this all the time. Nobody owes you anything. If you have breath in your lungs, you wake up today and you're healthy, well, guess what? God has created a new day for you. Maximize that opportunity. You know, sadly, recently, we just came back from Hawaii. Many of you are part of our YouTube channel, Seven Figure Squad, and we did a couple episodes from Maui. We went out there with 450 people. Sadly, we came back with 448. That's correct. We lost, sadly, two of our agency owners over there in Maui. They got swept away by the flash floods. Thankfully, their families are financially prepared with insurance, but we can never replace their lives. We'd rather have them here than a life insurance policy death benefit. But here's the thing. I tell my kids, you're lucky to be here today. You never know when the Lord's gonna call you home. And that's sadly, that's what happens. Life happens to all of us. It's inevitable. And if God has blessed you with today, God has blessed you with a new opportunity, God has blessed you with a position, make the most of it. Have joy in your heart, or what has been given can be taken away. Number three, consider doing this. Root out envy. Stop coveting and saying, I wish I had this, I wish I had that, or that person has this, or this person has that, I wish I had this. First of all, what are you doing? What did you do to maximize opportunities? What are you doing with the thing that God has placed before you? Are you maximizing this, or are you just withering it away? Are you withering opportunities? Are you taking advantage of other things that may not come tomorrow or the next opportunity? Sadly, sometimes when people look at opportunities, they say, oh, it's gonna come again, it's gonna come, I got another day, I got tomorrow. It's procrastination, and sadly, that's also working with the spirit of envy, because you're not willing to do the work that other people are willing to do. You're judging a product by its final, you're judging somebody by the final product. You don't see the hard, long nights. You don't see the effort. You don't see the sacrifice. And that's why most people envy. If you only knew the sacrifice and the commitment and the heartache that many people are willing to put through and put themselves through, you'd be saying, I may not envy their position because I'm unwilling to pay that price. I'd rather just be over here content with what God has given me. Whatever that case may be, whatever you feel God has called you to do, boom. But don't have envy in your heart. Root it out. And last but not least, seek to live wisely. Seek wisdom. See, oftentimes I reflect late at night from 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. This is my reflection times. So therefore I can prepare for my next day. And often during these times, I'm asking myself, what could I have done differently today? Who should I have called? Who should I have sought wisdom from? Was there something I could have played better? How did I play the scenario? Did I do right? I'm reviewing my own personal game tape throughout my day, because you know why? I'm looking for wisdom. And what is wisdom? Wisdom is not only education, but it's also experience and action put together. And going into positions the next day, going to another scenario says, okay, because I learned this from previous experiences, I know how I got burned. I know how I got taken advantage. I know how I lost money. I lost where this didn't go right in my favor. Well, I'm learning now. And more importantly, I've learned from other people's experiences. Not only am I taking my own experiences, but also leaning on the experiences of others. You know, Ray Dalio, who wrote the book Principles, he said, and Ray Dalio, if many of you don't know him, he's considered like the Apple of the hedge fund world, right? He's got billions and billions of dollars under his management. And make a long story short, he goes, I go into a lot of scenarios, even though I've been doing this for a long, long time, even though I have billions of dollars under my management, I still walk into scenarios and situations thinking that I am wrong and looking for somebody to convince me that I'm wrong, because I'm assuming that I'm wrong about a certain scenario, because I'm seeking to learn, I'm seeking to understand, I'm wondering if my position is actually right. See, that's seeking to live wisely and not thinking that you know everything. Listen, our brain, our time, our life is finite. Here's a cool part. We serve an infinite God. We serve an infinite purpose. We serve an infinite being saying, hey, we have God saying, hey, God has so much in store for you. And with you trying to wrap your mind around God's huge amount of glory and opportunity and wisdom to try to contain it, you're gonna blow your mind away. So that's why you got to live out every day to seek wisdom. What can I do today to improve? And here's the thing about winning the money game. Here's the thing about success, wealth, happiness, prosperity. Let me give you some encouragement. It's a process. Listen, there's nobody else that screwed this up more than the guy that's in this video right now. I screwed this up royally. And once I figured out, I didn't know everything. I remember telling myself at 30 years old, I said, God, I tried everything up until now my way. And by the way, I screwed up. I tell my kids, hey, kids, I'm sorry, your daddy screwed things up. I committed my 30s to say, you know what? I'm going to try it your way, Lord. And I took my entire 30s to repay back the mistakes of my 20s. And I hope you can avoid that mistake. I'm glad that you're watching this channel, because maybe some of you are blessed because you can make some detours, you can make some adjustments and avoid a lot of mistakes that I unnecessarily made in my life. And you can get to where you want sooner, health, wealth, contribution, long life, fulfillment, et cetera, not only sooner, but you're happiest and happier when you get there. Before I let you go, I want you to check out a couple of videos. Number one, it's the fastest way to lose money according to the Bible. And the second video here is how to make your dreams come true according to the Bible and according to God's purpose of what he would love to fulfill to you and through you. That being said, guys, I love doing your thoughts, your comments, your feedback, your questions. Drop it in the comments section below. Again, to remind you, we're looking for your help to title these Sunday night Bible studies, and we've got a contest. Person who gives us the right title to use for these Sunday night Bible studies is not only gonna get awarded $500, but we're also gonna give $500 to your church and charity or charity in your name. So please contribute what you think these Sunday biblical Bible studies about wealth, health, prosperity, and happiness should be on Sunday nights here on the Seven Figure Squad YouTube channel. That being said, guys, if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe and hit notifications to be alerted next time we upload our next episode. That being said, I'm your Money Smart Guy, and until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today. God bless you guys.